Hi, I'm Christian. I'm from Poland. I had a surgery and I had my cochlear implant implantation 3 years ago. And right now I'm testing the Sonnet III, so the newest model from Medel.
So, hi, I'm Ilona from Medel. Dzień dobry, Christian.
Dzień dobry, hello.
Jak się masz?
Good.
Good. Okay. Right, Christian, I know you have a rocker past and we've talked about and we kind of listen to a lot of the same music. Here you're playing in a band with your brother, so clearly music has been a real part of your family. How was your music experience before you lost your hearing?
Yeah, so music has always been part of my life and I live sort of like rocker life, and I was traveling from bus to hotel, from hotel to the stage. And I really cherish those moments.
Yeah, that sounds really special. But here we're talking about SSD. And SSD is where we hear in one ear and a profound severe hearing loss in the other ear. We know with SSD that there are a number of problems: difficulty hearing and noise, difficulty communicating at work or in social gatherings. What about localization? Listening effort, that's really something that can make you feel really, really exhausted. So Christian, how did it work when you had a sudden SSD?
Yeah, so when I lost my hearing in one ear, it affected my life a lot, especially my social life, because sitting in the really crowded places and noisy places, because of that I had headaches, and I also struggled because music felt differently, and I couldn't hear as before, and yeah, because of that, I had a lot of mental struggles.
Okay, that must have been really hard. So then you were looking for a solution. So why did you choose a Medel device?
Okay, so first of all, when I lost hearing in one ear, I didn't find a lot of information on the internet, so I did some research, I collected some materials, and finally I chose Medel Sonnet 2 because Medel's vision resonated with me, and eventually Professor Skarżyński proceeded with the surgery.
Okay, that must have been really, really exciting. But we've also heard a lot that people can become your non-users when you have SSD, because maybe you rely a bit more on your hearing ear and whatever. So what did the clinic recommend you to do to make sure you didn't become a non-user?
Yeah, so I was afraid of that also, but before choosing Professor Skarżyński's clinic, I visited several different clinics, and some of them didn't even recommend the surgery because of my SSD, because they told me that users used to stop rehab process, or they're not motivated that much to have audio processor, so they stop using it.
Okay, so what did you do specifically to make sure you didn't become a non-user and to train your hearing?
Yeah, I was motivated a lot to do everything. So I was listening to music, audiobooks, podcasts, and especially streaming music directly to the implant through the streaming feature. And it helped me a lot, and especially listening to the music that I already knew.
Okay, so based on getting your CI and going through all of this changing, this must have changed your listening experience. So how did that work?
Yeah, so after 2 or 3 months, I started recognizing single words. Mm-hmm. After a few months later, I was even able to listen to audiobooks directly through the audio processor. And I think most significant time was after 1.5 years, and Professor Arthur Lawrence helped here a lot to adjust audio processor programs when the sound level in my implanted side was compared to my normal hearing ear. And right now I even sometimes forget that I have an implant.
So. Really? Yes. With your bald head and you forget that? I'm impressed. Okay, so let's get a little bit technical here, because you have a really, as you're an engineer, you have a great insight into what your cochlear implant is and what it provides you. And I know that there's a lot of good, but also maybe there's not so good. But now when we look at MED-EL, with our very long electrode arrays, we have a better way of pitch matching. And we really discovered this when we first started implanting people with SSD. Because why? They could match this year and say, how did it go together? How did it sound? So you can compare your ears. So how did you find the differences? Was there the sound match, or how did it go with the frequencies and things like that?
Yeah, so actually when I listen on both sides, so implanted side and my normal hearing, I don't hear the difference. So I only hear the difference when I listen directly through the implanted side, so through the audio processor. And for example, bass and drums, it's great on both sides. I think for me it's the best sound, so bass and drums. Piano, it's quite different. At the beginning, it was hard to guess the pitch from the piano, but after a few years, it progressed, and I'm able to guess the pitch. Of course, it's not the same sound compared to my normal hearing, but the music is pleasant.
Wow. I think that's really profound to see how that went. But how about listening and noise and localization? Because that's also another issue.
Yeah, so the noise cancelling feature, in my opinion, is really great, and right now I can see it on really crowded places and recognize who is speaking, and I can localize the sound. Without audio processor, I'm not able to do it. And even when someone is on my left side, I don't have to, turn to the left to talk with someone, because I think right now it's great.
And I think with the research, we've really seen the improvement with localization, particularly with a longer electrode. Right, so you are wearing the Sonnet III, okay? And we know that with the Sonnet III, we've got really great new features. So it's waterproof, right? Great ergonomics, and we have direct integrated screening. So what is really exciting about it for you?
Yeah, so for me, a really great feature is a new flexible ear hook, because I can wear headphones the whole day and I don't feel anything. Also, as you mentioned, direct streaming. I don't need any devices to listen to the music or podcasts or whatever. And also waterproof. I'm not worried about rain. So it's also great.
Like we had yesterday. I think we had quite a bit of rain here, but it's going to be over. All right, now we move on. Half sound. Right. Okay, we know that getting a CI has been a good thing for you. That's what you told me, and it's certainly given you the real drive to go back into music, but this time on your own, so without your brother. So half sound seems to me quite obvious that it reflects your hearing loss in some way, am I correct?
Yeah, exactly. It's sort of like, reflection on my life and what happened. And I think it's also a really cool nickname, don't you agree?
Okay, but when I started listening to half sound music, you've changed your musical direction. Why?
Yeah, because, after coming back to the music world, I wasn't sure how it will go. Mm-hmm. So I started searching for a new style of music to be able to create by my own. So electronic music is this kind of music that I can create by my own. Of course, it was challenging because I haven't even listened to that kind of music before, so I had to learn. And I think it's good type of music also.
Well, let's see. Okay, if you want more, go to YouTube. But when I first heard this, I was like, are you the same person? Right, where's my rocker past? What happened? Okay, then I reflected on it. Escape. That's quite a title, I think, and quite an idea. So does it really have any link to your hearing loss experience?
Yeah, I called the track Escape because I think I can tell that cochlear implantation helped me to escape from the mental struggles.
The mental struggles. Right, but now this is where I get really excited. Yeah, cyborg. Okay. Right. Okay, so Christian is the influencer on YouTube. You have over 300,000 subscribers, right? And you put up a series when you got your Sonnet 3, the first one just opening the box that was really, really good. And you have over 70,000 views on that. Now, MedAl can't even manage that. That's why we need you, right? So you started doing this in Polish, and I think you know my Polish is like a few words, right? But then you moved on to English. So tell us the story.
Yeah, so when I started from the Polish content because when I lost hearing in one ear, I didn't find a lot of information, especially in the Polish internet. That's why I made some research and I started preparing content for my YouTube channel to help others. And then I saw that, I reached out to Polish audience, so I started also thinking how to make it even bigger. So Mario from MedAl inspired me to make it in English. I'm not native speaker, but I tried. And right now I share content in Polish and English, so I share interesting topic like this event. So here is camera.
Yeah,
so
I
will share.
I need to get my camera.
Yeah, I will
because
share the video
we want to do something.
And on the channel. We can also create a selfie on the stage and it will be also shared.
Yeah, so as I love a selfie, right?
Yeah.
We have decided we're going to do...
We are ready to go.
Yeah, are we ready? I think you're in charge because you've got longer arms than me.
So we can take a photo with the audience. And maybe also a short video. Everyone will be on YouTube.
Watch out. Christian, thank you. Dziękuję, Christian. We're waiting on you.
Have a nice day.
Bye.